So basically, the way this gets assembled is you have four counterboard holes right here, right? Okay, so these. Okay, so this is the Y axis secret, right? So this is gonna screw down to this linear row. Just like this. And it should be flat. You shouldn't have any head sticking up right there. This is the Y axis lead screw nut mount. And it's gonna screw in, so you have four counterboard holes here. It screws in here, here, and here. And this is the hot end mount right here. This is gonna screw into the side. So you have eight holes right here. This is just because it can be adjusted. You only need two. The two main ones you're gonna use is these two. These are just extra ones just in case you wanna do something crazy, like put a CNC spindle on it. Now notice these aren't actual holes. These are slots right here. So it allows you to get a little bit of adjustment. Have much adjustment, but you do have some. So it screws in just like that. Okay, so this is your hot end mount right here. Mounts to this C carriage. There's four tap holes here. So basically you have a set screw. This is what's gonna hold the hot end. Okay, so basically your hot end is gonna slide up here. You're gonna keep it flush with this top and you just lock it down. So you have a little bit of adjustment right here. So the way the C carriage is made, you can have four hot ends. So you can have two right here, and you have another mount, and have two right there. Now, because these are slots, it gives you a little bit of adjustment right there, right? So if you want to make sure you get all your hot ends the right height, you probably want to bring the carriage down and keep this loose and get them all the right height against the bed and then lock them down.
Except you do that for like 3 weeks.
Yeah, that's how that works.